In these lush mountains, Dagestan's rebels hide from Russian forces. Our journey here, a trip into the unknown.
We're on our way to the village where Canadian boxer William Plotnikov was killed in a gun battle with Russian forces.
15 minutes from the secure coastal highway, Utmayesh, a tiny town of 3,400 people.
We're being given special permission to go into the graveyard.
They are all moderate Muslims here and follow peaceful traditions.
Prayers being said.
Plotnikov's grave, not hard to find, at the cemetery's edge, a place for strangers. He was a convert to Islam.
Well, this does seem to be his grave. Plotnikov William Vitalievich, his father's name, born 3rd of May 1989, died 14th of July 2012, last summer.
The local imam tells me we had never seen him before. We didn't know anything about the rebels he was with. His father came from Canada and asked we bury him, a Muslim. Indeed, as I talk to local officials, they all tell me the same. The rebels he'd joined lived out of town. When I ask if they'd ever seen alleged Boston bomber Tamerlan Tsarnaev, they all tell me no. The town mayor tells me, I wish I could say we are safe, but since last summer, we worry. Can we take our cattle to the forests? On the edge of town, they take us to the farm where Plotnikov faced off with Russian forces.
The gate's been locked up. They've just opened the gate to let us in. This is the farm up here. Fields are overgrown. Looks like it's been deserted for a long time. There's vineyards over here, an orchard back up here. Looks like a shot-out van as well over here.
Six other rebels died in the firefight. 2 days later, Tsarnaev left the region. The farm owner survived the battle. In his police confession, he never mentioned Tsarnaev.
The farm appears stuck in time from last summer. The clothes are still hanging up here, a camouflage t-shirt, camouflage hat, and in the wall, this mud and straw wall, you can see the bullet holes up here, here, peppering it all over.
This official tells me they are trying to prevent such situations, counseling vulnerable young men, trying to build the local economy. Italians and Israelis, he says, have just visited. Both want to invest. Amid such fertile fields and bucolic charm, easy to imagine a better life, but reality seems never far away.
It feels quiet enough here now, but we've just learned in the past 12 hours, three policemen, one of them a senior counter-terrorism cop, have been killed in a shootout with rebels in a town not far from here. Two other policemen injured as well. It's typical of the battle that's going on daily here with the rebels. Nick Robertson, CNN, Utmayesh, Dagestan, Russia.